There's a car on the river. Oh, and a zombie chasing me. Nice. Arlene, god damn it. I don't want to stop because I got stuff in here. She's f***ing us up. Oh. You bitch. She gave us just about every critical you can get. Welcome back, everybody, to 7 Days to Die. I'm the Bearded OG, and then we're going to start off this episode by showing you a couple changes I made to the base based upon some comments that I got from some of you. So one of you guys said, bury the crate down into the ground, and then the zombies won't destroy it, and then you have to put stuff in for loot bags at the end of the night. So we did that. That was a very good idea. Thank you very much for that. And then another comment said to... recommended to put some scaffolding down below over here so that I can look down and shoot at any dogs or direwolves that are attacking the base. So that was also a very good idea. So I did that on both sides here, and as you can see, I've got really good visibility all the way along the front. I thought about maybe, well, no, that wouldn't actually work. I thought about maybe cutting a couple of these out, but then it just now occurred to me that that wouldn't work because that's where all the tower is, right? Which, by the way, we have fully upgraded now to concrete and expanded from what it was before. So what I did for the back was I created this little catwalk thingy here so that I can, you know, shoot at anything that's attacking the back, primarily, you know, dire wolves and dogs if we need to do so. So those are the improvements that we have made to the base. It's all fixed up and ready to go for Horde Night 35, which is tonight, by the way. So, yeah. Now, you'll also notice that I am sporting a nice, shiny new sniper rifle. Here's how that happened. Yeah, and so I tested it out a little bit afterwards, as you can see, with questionable success. and then I was mining last night, and a zombo came along and started banging on the hatch, so I opened it up and killed her, and she dropped this yellow bag with this lucky looter book in it. Cool. So, speaking of Lucky Looter, where are we at with those books? Yeah, we're only one away. Three, find more brass and loot, and then enemies will have a higher chance to drop loot. So, yeah, we're doing quite well. In fact, we're 6 of 7 away on that. We're also 6 of 7 away on Pistol Pete. Inflict 10% more damage with 9mm weapons, and shots fired at point-blank ignore armor. Plus, you can bullcrap 9mm. That's actually really good. So it'll be good to get that, and let's see, for sniping, we only need two more of the books here, so we already have the 10% more damage one, which is really good. So let's see, plan for today is we're pretty much ready to go for a Horde Night, so we're just going to go out and do a job or two, depending upon how our time goes, until Horde Night happens. So last night, I mined mostly coal and some nitrate to replenish my gunpowder because I have a lot, I've made a lot of pipe bombs. We have over 200 pipe bombs, so that's going to be my primary damage dealer overnight. But we'll also use the shotgun a little bit too, and we have 23 Molotovs. So here are all the pipe bombs I have. There's like just a crap ton of them. So we'll be taking those with us, of course, for Horde Night along with the Molotovs. And incidentally, we have 4 points to spend. And where am I going? I'm going here, and I'm going here. There we go. So we have 4 points. We need all 4 of those points. Got a screamer coming in to get to Perception 7. You know what, though? Before I spin those on... Let's put it into 6. We have to have that no matter what. But before we put it in there, let's go see if Rekt has one of those perception plug-in thingamadoodles that we can put on our helmet. Because if he does, then we can use that and save ourselves some points. So we'll run over there and check. I've got a few things to sell, too. And, you know, if you guys have not seen the last couple episodes, we are doing really well. I've got a full stack of coin there plus some, you know, extra in the bike. In fact, let's just grab all of this right now. I'm not going to bother fixing any of this stuff up just because I want to save repair kits for tools and things like that. Let's see. Let's put this in here. We're going to want this stuff on Horde Night too, so let's just put it in here so that way I don't forget to grab it when the time comes. Yeah, so we'll keep that in there, and then let's see, what do I got going on over here? I think we have, yeah, we're cooking up more stone, so let's make some cement. We made a whole crap ton of bullet casings there. And we also have, like 2 stacks of steel. I got a full stack there, plus 7, plus another stack here. So we've got quite a bit of steel that we've, been building up here. Oh, let's see. Let's put these in here to melt later. Put the bullet casings in here. We got this treasure map to do, too. Maybe we'll run and do that real quick. Get some more money. Because we like money. I was with my wife earlier today, and I went into the grocery store, and the Powerball's like up to 404 million right now. It's like, oh my God, can you imagine? Can you imagine? That would just be incredible. You have to be really careful that you don't let it fuck up your life, though, because that happens with a lot of people. But, I mean, who wouldn't want the chance, though, right? I certainly would. I'd take the chance. Oh, well. Is what it is. Yeah, so let's head on over to Rectipoo and see if he has one of those perception plugins. Hey, you old duffer.
Hey, jackass.
Hey,
can
jackass.
That back? You break any of my shit?
All right.
You're paying double.
I don't know where... What would those be considered? Mods? Maybe? Oh, yeah. Okay, so there's a fortitude mod. But, damn it, he doesn't have a perception one. That sucks. He does have a shotgun choke mod. What do I have on here for mods? I've got the sawed-off on. Okay, nah, let's just keep the sawed-off for now. Alright, so he doesn't have any mods. Let's just see what he does have for weaponry here. Orange steel sledgehammer. He's got a yellow... My God, I can't believe how expensive these things are. Those are more expensive than... I mean, quite a bit more expensive than even the tactical assault rifles. That's crazy. But, yeah, he doesn't really have anything I'm super interested in. Do you have any... What do you have for tools? You had a steel pick I'd be interested in. I'm not going to spend money on a steel shovel. Okay. So at some point I need to get those, but we're doing pretty good right now without them. So let's look at books. What is it that we... Oh, we want Forge Ahead because we're getting really close to the Kim bench. What does this one do? Fully automatic mode has an increasing chance to ragdoll an enemy with each hit. Sure, we got money. Let's buy that. But he doesn't have any Forge Ahead, so I don't think I'm interested in buying anything else from him right now. And we already looked at the mods. Got a couple of green pieces of armor.
All right. But, now that we're done doing business, get out of my store.
Where the hell am I going? Bike. This way. Okay. I'll tell you what. Let's go run and do that treasure first, and then we'll go do a job. We should be able to get both of those knocked out today. I suppose if I want to do the treasure, I should read it first, eh? What do you think? Oh, I didn't sell any of that shit to him. Crap. Thing is I don't know if I want to... Well, I'll tell you what. Let's go do the treasure, because there might be some things in the treasure that we could sell, too. And then that way we can take our buffs and maximize them as much as possible. All right, so this is Claude's treasure map. All right, and it is... Where is it? This way. How far that way? Not super far. Kind of far, but not super far. Okay, let's go do Claude's treasure map. Shit, that's a pretty big-sized river. All right, let's go around this way. There's a car on the river. Oh, and a zombie chasing me. Nice. Arlene, God damn it. I don't want to stop because I got stuff in here. She's fucking us up. Oh. You bitch. She gave us just about every critical you can get. What the fuck, man? I'm even wearing heavy armor. Here's a critical for you. God damn it. And she even got her infection up. Oh shit. Up to 3.4. All right. Take that. And we have an abrasion, so we can fix that with this. The sprains we can't really do anything about. At some point, I am going to put points into, you know, the medical doctor ones so that things like splints can fix all that. But, you know, I'm just kind of getting by without that for the moment. Okay. I kind of figured I'd be able to move through that water more quickly than I did, but... Huh. Okay. Yeah, I know you're hurt. I can't do anything about it. I guess, I can take a steroid. Do we have a steroid in here? Yeah, let's take a steroid. Okay, seems to be moving this direction. Is it too steep for you? Oh, it's Biker Boy. Fuck you. Okay, let's dig more down this way. What if they ever fix the southeast corner trick on this? Where you'd, you know, 9 out of 10 times you'd find it in the southeast corner. I mean, I wouldn't normally believe that, but I saw it happen myself. You know, more often than not, if I dug in the southeast corner, there it is, the southeast corner, we would find that, we'd find it. This, however, is kind of more like the northwest corner, though, so. It wasn't every single time, but I mean, it was often enough to where it was, you know, worth doing. 4 gold nuggets. Okay, that's decent stuff. I mean, none of it sucks, but... We got a lot of coin out of the last one. Of course, how much is 4 gold nuggets worth? Eh. Okay. All right, we got to get back across this damn river. I wonder if I have enough inventory space just to pick the bike up and hike across. Let's take a look here. Yep, we do. Okay. Looks like we can move a little bit faster in water than we used to be able to. Can I fire this underwater? Ooh. Wait. I must have just been right at the border there. All right. We don't need to sell all this stuff right now. So I'm just going to keep it in here. That. I don't think these are used for anything, right? Nope, no recipe. So we'll just sell those when the time comes. And yeah, I'll just leave that stuff in here. And then when we come back over here to sell later, we can grab all of this too. Hopefully I'll remember. Yeah, okay. I think we're good. Let's go ahead and refuel you and then get all of our medical stuff back in here. Okay, so we have a job, a clear and retrieve. I'm going to stop off at home, do a couple things, and I'll meet you over at that job location. All right, guys, we are here at the D. Smith residence. I'm going to go ahead and do those points, and we're not quite halfway there, but even if, you know, we start the Horde Night without getting Demolitions 4, you know, we'll probably get a few levels during the Horde Night, and then we can just update it at that point. Okay, so this is a clear and retrieve, and is there anything we want to try and double loot here? Let's see what's in here. Ah, this is the one that has the underground thingy. Okay. I don't know if it's changed at all from... Oh, pretty nice stuff from what it was before, but okay. Let's go ahead and start this party. And there is also a mailbox out front here that I had already previously looted. Paper. I mean, paper's nice. It's useful. That's how we make our shotgun shells. I've done this POI before, but I'm not real familiar with it. So, yeah, I think we're going to scrap that. And let's just put all this extra stuff in here. Okay, loot this again. Loot this again. And we'll also put this stuff away before we go down. Okay, let's do it. So glad we have the shotgun now. And our new sniper rifle. And our tactical assault rifle. And our crossbow. It's a beautiful thing. It's our bolt back. Nope, he's not going to do it. There's some concrete down here, or more specifically, cement. Take it. None of those are lootable. Zombies around the corner. Let's see what's in here. 14 blocks. fuck did she come from? Is it just her? I think so. All right. She's hiding right behind there. Sneaky. Sneaky, sneaky. I'll take those. In fact, let's take those. Then we can keep from getting infected. Oh, nuts. I was hoping for another forge ahead. So close to the chem bench. I like that we have some doors that we can use here. Very useful. And let's get rid of that stuff. Take the water here, some meds. Okay. Yeah, this is really good, man. We got several retreat spots behind doors that we can run to when we need to. Notice I said when we need to. Not if, it's when. All right, up the stairs we go. It's locked. Yeah, I see two red dots. One of them's a cop. Okay, we got three red dots. God, I love this shotgun. It's awesome. It is awesome sauce. So that should take care of the ones in the immediate vicinity. At least that's a theory, right? Food. Eat those right now. All right. Let's loot in the kitchen. There's another one. I think chili dogs was the last food recipe that we learned. I guess we'll eat that too. Nope. Pick two coffee. Possible zombie in that closet there. And possible zombo in that closet there. Say goodnight, Gracie. Oh, shit. Okay, we got someone else coming. Wherefore art thou? You're stuck behind the wall here? Yes. Feral Edgar. Hey, let me see your head. Have I mentioned how much I love this shotgun? I don't know if I mentioned that yet. Thing is, too, is we only have... I think we only have one... No, we have 2 points in a boomstick. Okay. We'll work on that. Yes, indeed, we will. Yeah, give me that back. Take those satchels upstairs. Okay, there's probably Zeke in that room there. Let's open that up so we can get the hell out of here quickly if we need to. And also invite running zombies hordes in. Kind of a catch-22 situation, right? Oh, shit. That scared me. Hit it. And die. Paper. Paper or plastic? Nowadays, it's no thank you. I'm not going to pay extra for a bag. At least that's the way it works in Colorado. Okay, we still can have a Zeke in here. Nope. Not this time. Okay, let's scrap that. Scrap these. Scrap these. Not gonna take up an inventory slot with that stuff. We have enough to make a duct tape. Well, actually, that won't save us a slot, but that's fine. We need to make a duct tape anyways. Always need to make duct tape. All right, let's go upstairs. Zombo closet's over there. Where you at? Well, there you are. Eat some buckshot, Edgar. Trying to get to that guy. Antibiotics, very nice. I've got two big antibiotics now. There's our satchel. And two big antibiotics and one herbal. But I'm actually out of honey at the moment. Did everybody come out of all these rooms? There we go. Explosives. I'm liking it. Looks like they want us to go out that way, eh? Did we miss anything over here? No, I guess not. I'm gonna leave that chair, actually. Buzzards? Don't care about feathers anymore. We are now using plastic to make arrows. Well, okay, we have a piece of scrap iron, so I guess we'll scrap that. I'll throw those bones out if we need to make space. Also don't need 13 nitrate. Up the stairs we go. What could possibly go wrong up here? Lots. Okay, let's close that door. Get him to come through here, and then we have the spikes and the barbed wire to work for us. Two more red dots. One more red dot. This was a pretty easy tier 3 to do just because of the layout of the building and all of the doors we can hide behind and stuff. And having these spikes and barbed wire here. Yeah, so this is a very easy, I mean, comparatively, right? Tier 3 to do. I like it. Sure, we'll take that. Definitely going to take this. Don't see anything behind there. $6 make you hella. Medium food pile. Gotta be getting close to the next recipe, whatever that may be. Okay, and then there's another purse right here. And then the fat loots. Is that everything, I think? Yeah. Another helmet light mod. Nice. Okay, that way when we switch helmets, we can put it on there. Excuse me. Okay, let's head on back to Wrecked and do our turning. Then we gotta get ready for Horde Night. Okay, let's... do we want to sell all this right now? Maybe not. I think we'll just sit on this. We'll probably end up selling that too, because we already have one that's a yellow. And I don't think we want to sell any of the rest of that. That's currently in our inventory. If you're wondering, the reason I'm not selling it yet is just because one way till we have a lot of stuff to sell or something expensive to sell or buy, and then that way we can do all of our buffs and do it all together. And speaking of which, let's actually buy that sugar butts too.
Get lost. I'd shake your hand, but I bet you got dysentery.
What does this give us? Repair tool crafting. We already have the nail gun. I mean, that gets us one more closer to the motorcycle, I guess. 500 cement's kind of nice. But yeah, let's take vehicle adventures.
Money talks, bullshit walks.
I think we've already looked at his inventory.
If you don't like food, you can always go dumpster diving.
Okay, so I don't think any of these are in town, with maybe the exception.
I don't like you, but maybe I'll change my mind if you do something for me.
Yeah, no, I think that's a little ways out of town, too.
You must be half a zombie already.
Okay.
Or got shit for brains to cross me.
None of those are in town. This one is...
I got work to do if you don't mind getting your hands dirty.
I think that one's in town. So
you
let's
better
take
not
it.
Fuck this up.
I know it's just a tier
I'll
one,
cut
but
your
that's
goddamn
okay.
Goddamn throat!
I cut your goddamn throat. Okay, we have a sugar butts for when we do our big selling sesh. But I'm gonna actually take that back with me and put it with the pumpkin cheesecake and the glasses and all that. Our first victims are arriving. What if we're gonna get any demolishers tonight? Guess we'll find out, won't we? Got a military guy. Let's get over here because I got the sawed off mod, so we want to be pretty close to these guys to get maximum damage in. Well, not that close. As soon as we level, we're going to put a point into demolitions, and we'll be level 4 demolitions. Oh, grab it. Oh, just about got it. Hey, fuck off. Yeah, shotgun's doing work, baby. Get up nice and close here, and we'll just kick the crap out of him.
Yeah.
Is that another bird? Must be. Ow. We're taking him out as fast as we can pull the trigger. Oh, maybe you're the one that's hitting me. Must be. Yeah, I might want to think about raising this cage another block. Not really any reason not to do that, you know? Check things. Yeah, that's taking a little bit of damage there. It's taking a couple hits too. All right, let's use some explosives. Okay, we got our level. Let's go to perception and demolitions expert. 40% increased damage, 66% chance to cripple, 30% greater chance to dismember. I'll take it. Get one down below there. A couple of them, maybe. Man, buzzards are a real pain in the ass tonight. Let's try a Molotov through here. Hopefully it works. Yeah, okay. Much better. You never know about these damn Molotovs though, right? Look at all the bags down there. Look at all the blue bags down there. Oh man, that's a shame. Those will all disappear before morning. Oh. Close to that one. Alright, let's try another Molotov. Yeah, that works pretty good. Just gotta aim right through the center. Good bang for our buck on that one. All right, let's check repairs. I haven't really given them a whole lot of opportunity to do too much damage up here. That one is taking a few hits, as is that one. Okay. It'll be nice when we get the chem bench, because then we can, and start mining gas oil shale, because then we can make a bunch more Molotovs. It's interesting how the fire follows them all the way down, though. They must, like catch on fire and then You know, then they drop down and catch everybody else on fire, I guess. I'd try and grab those bags, but they're gonna pound me if I do. Yeah, I think that's a... Well, I don't know. Maybe it's just all the ones that are on fire up here that are falling back down, and it looks like they're... You know, they're burning... brought the fire down below, which they did for themselves, that's for sure. Yeah, that's working really well now for Molotovs. 3850 XP. Pretty good. Pretty darn good. Got lots of pipe bombs left. Off there, big mama. Okay, we better heal up here. We've been taking a few hits. And let's check repairs. Everything's looking pretty damn good. Oh! It's funny when they get up here. They crawl so fast because I think they're going along the scaffolding. Ow! That hurt. A little bit. 3100 XP on that deal. Oh, cop explosion. I didn't even know there was a cop there. Burn, baby, burn. Got a double on that. Nice. There's a copper. And we got the next skill point. Not paying attention and forgetting to light those. You guys told me though that if you throw a Molotov down and then a pipe bomb blows up on it, it'll light up the Molotov too. Looks like that's what happened. Nice. That way they're not wasted. Okay, let's check repairs here. Looking good. Nice. Cops are showing up now. Challenge kill cop zombies is complete. Oh, I'll bet you we'll get a nice reward for that. I love it. Got a double there. No blowing up, dude. That is not allowed. Still seem to be do pretty good damage from that far away, even with the shot sawed-off mod. Ow! Let's go ahead and heal up and check our locks here. It's all looking good. A little splash damage, but nothing too bad. Haven't really had any dogs show up yet. Not that I've been able to notice. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, they broke ladder. Okay, that's the first ladder they broke. I'll probably add more ladders to it for next time. Because they can crawl across them sideways. It's that spot right down there that's really vulnerable. I wonder if when they fall down, they're hitting at that spot. Not really sure. Look at the bags down there. That's crazy. The cop blew up. All right, guys. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to just time lapse the rest of the night. But of course, if something super crazy happens, we'll definitely show it on camera. And I'll see you guys in the morning. Enjoy the music. We'll be right back. Did we actually kill the Horde? I think we killed them all, you guys. I didn't even know that was possible. I thought they kept coming till morning. Holy shit. All right, let's get down and get the bags. Let's be ready just in case. Whoop. We killed the Horde. Oh my goodness. Okay. Let's just grab and we'll look later. Going after the blue ones first, of course. And we'll just put everything in here. Okay, I think that's all the blue ones, right? Yeah. Oh, steel parts, nice. I was hoping to get some of those. Goodness gracious. So much stuff. Here, let's just put everything in there. Just a little nervous. Oh, more steel parts, even better. Okay. I think that's it for the loot. Wow. I can't believe we killed them all. We kicked the ever-living shit out of those dudes and dudettes. All right, let's see what we got here. What is this? This is a farmer outfit. Crop harvest bonus by 20%. That's pretty damn good. Okay, we'll hang on to that and use it for harvesting crops, of course. You know what we need to do? We need to go back and get that nerd chest before we start reading all these books. It doesn't count for these kind of books, but for the magazine books, it does. And it doesn't look like we have any normal books. Okay, yeah, let's run back and grab that nerd outfit. Challenge, survive 5 blood moons is complete. Fan-frickin-tastic. All right, let's see. I got that two nerd outfits right here. What are we wearing? Yeah, we'll just swap those. Oh. We have an amber alert going off. That's never a good thing. Let's see. Everything is secure. So let me actually put a few things away before we go back out there, because we have so much shit. I'll just put mundane things away that aren't a big deal. Okay, so let's grab all of the magazines out of here first. Those are all just, you know, ones we've already read that we'll sell, of course. We're not really getting anything super good in terms of tools or weapons, but it was still a pretty damn good haul. And I'm really thrilled that we got steel tool parts. Okay, so we have 2 tactical warfare. We have 6 armored up. Nice, now we can make quality 3 armor and explosives. Ah, this gets us to the chem bench. Nice. 2 fists. Wait for that to finish there for that, because that'll show us chemistry bench, I think. 4 handy lands. We got a rifle world. Okay, contact grenade. Knuckle wraps, don't care about that. Shotgun. Spears, iron quality. 1, okay, vehicle, 5, harvesting tool. Okay, hopefully this will get us to level 3 steel tools. Yes, it did. Okay, cool, because we have 3 steel tool parts. That means we can make ourselves a yellow steel pick, which will be a really nice upgrade from what I currently have. 4 medical journals, herbal antibiotics, okay. Six salvage tool. This should get us into the ratchet, I'm thinking. Yes, look at that. Fantastic. Okay. Quality too, even better. Does that require special parts? Oh, I don't know if it does. Handgun, 4. Okay, we can do pistol quality 4 now. Sledgehammer. Oh, pistol quality 5, even better. Okay. And then 4 handy lance for repair tools. Nail gun quality 2, nice. And this is actually probably the grand prize, I'm going to say, because it gets us our Kim bench. Huzzah! Look at that. That's a beautiful thing. Indeed, it is. Okay, and then the farmer outfit's actually pretty nice. We got raider boots, one legendary part, the 3 steel parts, of course, which is kind of the other prize in my estimation. Let's go ahead and drink those now. And then, you know, just a bunch of ammo and some other stuff. So, pretty nice haul. Let's just throw everything we can in there. And that gets us all of this stuff. And then I can go sort it out back at the house. Ladies and gents, this base is a really damn good base. And it did help a lot, you know, for me to add those extra grates so I could see down here. But we didn't have any dogs at all for the whole night, as far as I could tell. And, you know, only one ladder broke this time. I'm sure, you know, those other ones are probably pretty damaged. Let's see. Yeah, not too bad in through here. Right in this spot here, though. See, yeah, that one's pretty damaged. They just take a lot of damage right in this spot. That's just interesting. But what I'll probably do for the next Horde Night is I'll probably add more ladders. Just, you know, so that way we have a better chance of them not breaking all of them, because then that would make the base not work. There's almost nothing back here in terms of damage. And I don't see any blocks that are, like, close to being destroyed. There's certainly, you know, some damage, but nothing major at all. It won't take me long at all to get this thing fixed up and ready to go. So, yeah, my plan is the only thing different that I'm going to do for the next Horde Night is just add more ladders. You know, maybe another row here and another row here. I mean, we could even probably add ladders on both sides all the way up, but I don't know if that's really necessary. We didn't get any demolishers, though, too, so demolishers are going to be tricky when that does happen. So we'll have to be really careful with them if we can. You know, grenades and pipe bombs will set off the no-no button on a demolisher. So we're going to have to try and, you know, kill them with careful headshots. Okay, let's do a couple more things before I let you go. We have a couple challenges. In fact, we have the cop challenge that we can go turn into wrecked. And we have some points too. We have 2 points. And so since we're still working perception, we definitely want Deadeye up to level 4. And why don't we max out Lucky Looter? I think we will do that. Adds 25% to loot bonus and looting is 80% faster. Let's just do that. And then we're going to get, you know, we're going to get Penetrator maxed out for sure. And salvage operations. And then after that, I'll probably eventually, you know, get perception maxed out so we can get level 5 in some of these. But I think we're going to switch back over to strength and, you know, start getting our shotgun and our mining skills and all that up a little more in our heavy armor. So that's the tentative plan for all that stuff. Challenges. Let's see. We have survive 5 blood moons. That gives us 5,000 XP. And we have a kill cop zombies, which gives us 10,000 XP and rare items. Okay. And I think that, again, I think we go turn that one into wrecked. So let's go do that real quick before I let you go. While we're here, let's put some sellables in here. But again, we'll wait until we have a big selling day before we sell any of this stuff. Sledgehammer could go in there. That could go in there. All of these books, I'll probably just scrap all this armor for the parts, most likely.
If you didn't we agree your first job was going to be free? Damn, this is all I can spare.
Man, that is so valuable right there, that solar cell. But one solar cell right now, it's just not doing us a whole lot of good. This is tempting. Maybe we should do this so we can just grow big, huge crops of supercorn for making money. Another crucible would be nice too, but not necessarily critical at this point. Of course, four legendary parts. I'm thinking for the here and now, this is probably going to be our best bet. Either that or the crucible. But thing is, we already have a crucible. We don't have the supercorn recipe yet. And I think it's the last one you get with the books, maybe. So, or no, I think the potatoes are the last one. Yeah, let's go with the supercorn. All right. Did you reset?
What the hell do you want this time?
I think he maybe did reset. Let's just take a quick look at what he's got here. Steel sledge, baseball bat. No, I don't think he did. I think that he had this last time, if I remember correctly. Let's look at tools. Yeah, this is the same stuff he had before. Okay.
I'd go broke with more customers like you.
Very good. Now we can start raising our own supercorn. What I envision in the near future, not here, but wherever our permanent home ends up being, which I'm still planning on that to be the desert at this point, we'll probably grow a big ass field of supercorn and just grow it and then make tons of money and then have piles of money and nothing to do with it. nothing to spend it on. But hey, it's still fun anyways, right? Who doesn't want piles of money even if they can't use it? All right, you guys, this was an awesome Horde night. Super, super successful. Super happy, pleased. Super happy, pleased? Yeah. With the base. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my chemistry bench made. And I'll just show you what that requires. We'll track that. I have everything, including the beaker, because we did get that beaker. So all that stuff is easy lemon squeezy. Wait, do I have 5 acid? I think I do. You know what? Maybe we don't. That would be in here. Oh, we do. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Easy. We can make 2 chemistry benches. Well, not 2 because we don't have 2 beakers, but we don't need 2 at this point. So yeah, I'm going to get that made. I'll probably plop it down, I don't know, right here maybe. So we can start using it to make gunpowder and other things much more efficiently. I'll go get the base, repaired. It won't take me long at all to do that. And then in the next episode, we're going to hit the POIs hard in this town because I want to move. It's time for us to move. We can always come back here to use that base or, you know, we'll build something else, but maybe even another one of those. I don't know. Wherever we end up living permanently. But all that being said, thanks everybody for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And if you did, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, share out the video, and we'll catch you all in the next episode. Bye-bye.